the process of the answer to your prayers. Elijah said, go. He came back and said, there's what? At that point, many people give up. Because they are still ruled by the physical, by their senses. When I say in Jesus' name, you know, I'm saying this because you are going to step up and do the same thing. Somebody hear what I'm saying? And you can still repeat it again now. When you say in Jesus' name, you are healed. You check it because you know it's going to happen. Yes or no?
Yes.
You don't say you are healed in Jesus' name and I leave it alone. Because you are sure, you say check it, do what you could not do before. That's what he said. He said, go now. How many times?
Seven times.
Yeah, that guy didn't give up. The next verse says, servant came back and said he saw a hand. Abi? And said, go and tell what? Ahab. That he should run or else the rain will catch up with him. Sometimes when we are in retreats and we are praying and we fix our gaze, our desire on one point, for example, we want to hear, for example, let me give an example. We're praying two years ago, yes, that the Lord Jesus will appear to one of our fathers in the faith. Will appear to our fathers in the faith generally. I won't go into the details, but we're asking that the Lord Jesus will appear to our fathers in the faith. And when necessary, where corrections needs to be made, by his mercy, he will confront them and bring corrections. That week, he appeared. I'm not going to go into details, but to a very, very famous father in the faith, one of the largest donations. And we had the news by the next week that a friend who was in the meeting came and said, I prayer, God answered it. That he got to church on Sunday, and he was hearing it around in church. Did you hear what happened to this week? I began to realize that if we decide on a thing now, truly the Bible is right, we will have it. How do you fast track it? Expectation. Can you say expectation?
Expectation.
Start checking for it. So when I decree in the name of Jesus, we receive miracle alerts.
Yeah.
If you believe it, then check. But we don't have to wait. Hold on. We don't have time. Alright? So the next thing to do is to what? Is to check. Because your checking in the natural is confirming that you believe what has happened where in the supernatural. That's a key right there many Christians don't know. January this year we're pressing 21 days, fasting, praying. And then one night, well, I think it was a Friday, we just felt like, you know, releasing the judgment of God upon the wicked. And we said, Lord Jesus, let Nigeria cover the wicked. Let all those who are wicked, who are just wicked, just chosen to be wicked, let Nigeria cough them out. And we judge them and we call them to glory. I can't forget that night. I was in tears. I knew that, you know, the anointing came strongly for it. To let wickedness go on is injustice. That's not love. Because somebody else is dying by the reason of the wicked. So is that he's getting saved or he's called? One of the two of them was happening. Somebody hear what I'm saying? Oh. And that night, we decreed it. Before I went to sleep, I checked online, Facebook, WhatsApp, to see if anything had shown up. 1 hour after the prayer. I woke up the next morning, the first thing I checked was to see quickly, has anything shown up? I saw news. Over the night, I won't mention the name. But this guy who killed 70 people on New Year's Day in Port Harcourt. Some of you know what I'm talking about. On New Year's Day, how many of you know what I'm talking about? Aha. They were rounded up, him and his assistant, and they were killed. I saw the body on Facebook. I said, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. We came for the prayer meeting and I said, it has happened though. You don't know, but faith is a muscle that you exercise with use. The day is coming when that muscle will be needed to even save your life. That's not the day to practice. I'll say it again. If the day comes and you are not ready, see, God has not failed because you died. He does not cease from being God because you failed. David killed his Goliath because he was confident in something God had done before. Abi, he made reference to it again and again and again. By God, I killed a bear. Another time, I killed a lion. Do you know what it means to kill a lion? You just read stories and just go on. You know, the Bible is strange. A 17-year-old boy killed a lion. Killed a bear. Have you even killed goats? Some of you see chicken, you run. Some of you see a cockroach, but just cockroach. Some of you rat, you run. Somebody saw a lion. It's just sheep that you can keep it. Kill the sheep. What's there? Only one. David went after it and grabbed the sheep. What kind of boy was that? Hey! That a normal human being? No. So when he was saying, I'll kill this circumcised Philistine, he was not joking. He had rehearsed. Can you say rehearsed? Hallelujah. Yes, somebody hear what I'm saying? Yes, go to secondary schools and go and start rehearsing. Yes, I beg you in the name of God. That instruction God gave you. Stop wasting your time now. Start rehearsing. The confidence you are speaking with came from a lot of years. I didn't start church. In secondary school, I watched the demon scream, leave me alone. I said, pack them up, pack them up. I still have the videos. In case I forget, 2012, 2013, 2014. The day will come when they will think somebody is a magician. Can you say rehearse? Yeah. As you keep rehearsing, as you keep practicing, the speed at which it happens is going to increase. That's the reason for rehearsal. Forget that you have prayed in the Holy Ghost. Go and do what? Yeah. Go and rehearse. Don't be afraid to fail.